gonna start Tales of the Borderland, or the new Tales from the Borderland. See, check this out.
Think you've seen it all, huh? Think you know all there is to know about Vault Hunters, Bandits, Corporations, and Nobody Loser types? Well, you don't know skagdiddly. Take Promethea, for example.
Promethea?
A civilized place, as far as planetary-sized piles of excrement go. A planet still recovering from its war with the Malevan Corporation. The rival Atlas Corporation is in bad shape.
Reese.
Reese Strongfork, the big shot CEO with the regrettable mustache, is scrambling. He's on the cusp of something big. But he's not the only one. And into this pressure cooker steps Dr. Anuradha Dhar, genius inventor, socially awkward, do-gooder type.
Socially
she works
awkward.
For Atlas, been tinkering with a big, award-winning idea. Her brother, Octavio Wallace Dhar, Meridian City's most well-known man, at least in his own mind, he's convinced his big break is just around the corner. And Fran Miskowitz, purveyor of Reese Strongfork's favorite Froger flavor.
Froger.
She's hoping for a big insurance payout after that regrettable Malawan laser incident. So, you're probably asking yourself, what makes these three so special? And the answer is nothing. Yet.
Ho ho.
You're free now. Go. Be free. Run.
Oh, no.
Run.
Not again.
What's that gonna do? They're just gonna die.
Morning.
What? I mean, good morning.
Seriously. Again?
Yep. Another busy day. Work, work, work. Am I right?
By channeling the Iridium's energy through a multiphasic refraction lens, I can reproduce the, as yet, inexplicable powers of the Sirens.
Science.
Maybe not the winged thing, which is so cool, but crucially, the ability to manipulate an object safely through space-time.
Damn.
I'm Anu, the ultimate Siren fangirl, but for totally scientific reasons, I swear, and I'm so close to replicating the signature move of my all-time favorite Siren, Lilith. R.I.P.
Oh. Your partner in science.
Anu.
As I was saying, in addition to forever altering the nature of conflict, vis-a-vis offering a non-lethal resolution, my device could also change the world.
Anu, better world of worlds? Me.
For the better. Imagine, a way for people to solve their problems without killing each other.
I literally can't.
I just have to figure out how to actually bring back the objects I phased away. And also, where they go. And also, what happens to them. Simple. Interdepartmental demonstration scheduled for 2 weeks from today. Dr. Anuradha Dhar signing off.
Oh, snap. 2 weeks? Really? It's going to be ready by then? You always seem so hesitant to put a timeline on this bad boy, so you know, 2 weeks. Wow.
Yes.
It
will be ready. I mean, it really sort of has to be. Like, it has to be. It's So important. And also almost time for our quarterly reviews. All I've got to do is just figure out the next step. That's it. There's got to be something I'm missing.
Figure it out with, like, your intuition or with your tech goggles?
I would like to think both.
Maybe start with the tech goggles, though. There's a button on the side.
Okay, goggles. Let's try a diagnostic. So, for starters, I should probably put an actual power source in there, huh?
You needed the goggles for that.
Now, where did I put that iridium ore?
Great.
I remember you securing it a while ago. You said, I'll definitely remember where it is.
Huh. Now that I look at the Jabberman translator with fresh eyes, I realize I may have made a miscalculation in the translation matrix. For all I know, they could have been spouting philosophy.
Not gonna fix it? One, two, three, four.
And would a clearer-headed Anu remember the code to her safe for once?
What? Q, E, Q... What the fuck? Totally intentional.
Why does this lock always jam? Didn't we put in an IT ticket for this?
Have you tried turning it off and on again?
What? That's impossible.
Just try the combination again, I guess.
God damn it. Oh, money, money, money.
Better grab some money for lunch while I've got this bad boy unlocked.
Did you say lunch? You buying?
Cheapskate.
Were you seriously about to scam me without my consent? Not cool. We really need to work on your people skills, boss. If you want to know what's in my pocket, ask.
Fong, can you tell me what's in your pocket?
It's a Vaultlander figure. Some of the other lab assistants and I like to play before work. I totally creamed Roberts this morning, and this was my sweet reward.
Are you not going to show me? That makes sense. I figured it'd be in there, but, you know. Huh?
It'd be great if you found that iridium shard, because you're the only person who knows where it is.
In the toolbox, maybe? My trusty tools. So much potential for science in these simple implements. And what's that? Oh, Anu, really? Got you.
Left the rare and incredibly expensive ore inside the toolbox again, didn't you?
Yep.
Maybe.
Slap.
Oh. I love that hum. It's like it's singing.
Like a siren song.
Like a song of the future. A better future with less bloodshed. Where we use innovation and technology to help people and protect life, not casually destroy it as a matter of course. Like, don't you know?
I know, like profit-focused warmongers with no moral compass beyond the almighty dollar.
Exactly.
AKA Atlas's motto.
No cruelty, no killing, no compromise.
You're a revolutionary boss.
Ooh, who are we rising up against?
Thar? What? Timmy? Oh, Timmy.
Not that kind of revolutionary, Timmy. Don't worry.
I won't. Revolutions typically generate a 30% increase in market share. Good for business! In fact, the only thing better for business than revolutions are the vicious campaigns of suppression by the ruling elite that inexorably follow.
Don't you think we should maybe, I don't know, not root for people who resort to violence and total upheaval as a means to an end?
Yeah.
Upheaval is integral to progress, and violence begets violence, which, as I mentioned, is great for business.
Right. Anyway, are you here for something in particular, Timmy?
Yes, please. I'm here on behalf of Mr. Strongfork to inquire why our company's test subjects are somehow liberated.
I'm sorry. Test subjects?
The Jabbers.
Liberated.
Correct. Your comprehension level is impeccable. You should have no trouble explaining why the Jabbers are loose. Again. They're currently running amok down the laboratory hallways. The janitorial staff is prepping for what I like to call go Jabber grabber time.
All right. It was me. You caught me. I did it. I let the Jabbers go.
Yes, we know. I apologize if my tone was misleadingly chipper instead of appropriately accusatory.
Wait, what?
If it's any consolation, the footage from this instant was captured at a much more flattering angle than the footage of you releasing the Jabbers those other times.
Don't they deserve to be free?
Oh, I'm not authorized to dispense ethical judgments about Atlas.
Ethical judgments.
Well, now that we've got that straightened out. Ah, Dr. Dar, you have an update to your calendar incoming. It's an appointment with Mr. Strongfork.
Oh, I can check my schedule to see.
The appointment is now.
Oh, and, what is it regarding?
It's a reprimand session for Mr. Strongfork to reprimand you.
Oh. Wait, better not go empty-handed.
Good luck.
UK Games presents Gearbox Software Game. New Tales from the Borderlands. Mogul, also you.
Hey, Papa Girardi! I can smell your space calzones from here!
Ah, thanks! I need a new name for them!
I'd also need to stop doing that problematic accent!
Yeah, I know.
Miss Johnson! Did you get a cybernetic leg? That thing's straight fire.
Oh shit! Legit fire.
Jesse, how's it hanging, dude?
You know, Octavio, it's a brand new day, filled with endless possibilities and excitement.
Sounds like it.
Junko.
New Agorex, who it is?
Another new device? Come on, Octavio. It's Radon. But listen, I'm almost done with this demolition. Wanna head to Paco's for tacos?
Man, it pains me to say that tacos are off the menu. Mostly because I'm broke.
So don't eat any. Just come, you can watch me.
Watch you. How's that any fun?
Octavia.
Oh. God, jeez.
I anticipated your arrival and have been waiting in a location that would not obstruct others.
No, I wasn't scared. Like, at all.
Your biometrics appear otherwise. Your voice resembles a 9-year-old girl's.
9-year-old girls are the future, so thank you.
That was
the publication you requested.
Kilo Flynn. Damn, you gotta be one with the buttons. They go by fast.
Come on.
It's all the same.
Your biometrics read extreme disappointment.
It's Forge's super successful Dirty 30. It lists the planet's most promising, innovative entrepreneurs, and I'm not on it. Again.
Have you accomplished some extraordinary business transaction to warrant your acknowledgement on this list?
I survived Malawan's invasion. And I'd like to think that my social influence has kept the city together after the war left it in damn near ruins.
No would have been a more succinct answer.
Yeah.
Look, I'm working on it.
What? This list is merely the opinion of other humans. You should not value it.
Fair.
As a machine, I find this accolade pointless to strive for.
You're right. Who cares about some dumb list of super successful entrepreneurs?
If you'd like to gain more work experience, I know people who could hire you as a meat target for new assassination bots.
What?
That's okay.
The pay is terrible, but the medical benefits are also terrible.
Then why would you take it?
Perhaps you are disappointed, but look on the bright side. Many of these celebrated humans have contracts on their heads. Bivington Bradwick, for example, has numerous bounties on his life, but no assassination bot can kill him. He is rich and important enough that he never has to leave his home or do anything for himself. You, however, are not on this list. You're anonymous, unrecognized, a nobody. This is beneficial for your survival.
Exactly.
But not beneficial for my image. I mean, all the best business people have probably at least killed someone to succeed. Something to warrant a bounty anyway. I'm doing whatever it takes to maintain appearances. Come on, if there was a list of all the best assassination bots, wouldn't you want to be on it?
No.
Hey, that list? Forget it. I didn't even want to read it. I just wanted to see if you would read it.
What?
That logic does not make sense.
No.
That's because I'm a future business genius. I'm playing four-dimensional chess.
I'm a sentient computer. I'm literally playing 300 games of four-dimensional chess right now. And I just won.
Damn.
Yeah, well, I'm more dangerous.
I've killed 963 people. You have killed no one. Ah, another checkmate. And another. And
I get it, man.
Despite your erratic behavior today, I'm in need of your assistance.
Sorry, I'm busy networking, innovating, shaking hands. After Malawan killed nearly half the merchants in the city, we've all needed to make new contacts.
This would be an actual job, with money. Your various business concepts like financing, marketing, public appeal.
Kidding! I'm not busy. Totally pranked you. You just got Octavio'd.
Interesting phrasing. Perhaps I'll adopt that.
Well, that's kind of my thing, but...
Now, on to business matters.
Yeah, fuck.
You'll aid me, as you have before, in confirming the names of my targets before I shoot two ion slugs into their brain. To talk. You have a mouth. You will prove exceptional.
Will I be... killing anyone?
All assassinations will be done by me, as prescribed by the Assassination Bots Guild. We have a strong labor unit.
Whatever it takes to get my business off the ground.
Do you actually have an idea for your business?
Not at all.
Tons! A few. I'm working on it!
Son of a skank-kissing rat's ass!
Just fucking put it in there!
Congratulations, Francine Miskowitz! It has been 90 days since your last uncontrolled outburst of rage!
Alright, alright. Let's make it to 91. Get to work.
Take pride in your ability to maintain a positive attitude, even though a Malabar space laser decimated your Froger chunk and subsequently reduced its Echo Net Yowl rating by 3.5 stars.
Damn.
Thank you, SponsorBot.
For your queen.
Your Yowl rating is now negative 3.5 stars.
Thank you, SponsorBot. As soon as the insurance money comes in, this place will look good as new.
Damn.
Forever drowning in an ocean of capitalist indifference.
This dude's useless.
Congratulations, you are not thinking about it.
Son of a...
You don't have to do this. You have a choice. Think before you act.
Oh. Oh no. Oh, jeez.
It has been
0 days.
I'm fine. It's not a backslide.
Oh, it's a backslide. All the way back to pure animal rage.
Everything's gonna be just fine.
My new Slaughter-O-Matic combat vegetable knife slices artichokes as easily as arteries.
We're not open yet. And, lore. How's business treating you, handsome?
Not bad. If there's two things you can count on Prometheans buying,
is that guy from Tiny Tina's? Sounds like the guy.
Place looks as charming as ever. I thought the insurance money was supposed to come through by now.
Claims guys coming by today. They've been jerking me around, saying I have to pass some sort of final interview to get my cash.
How dare they not trust a kind old lady like you? Want me to shoot them? It's been a while since I shot anyone. A week, at least. Still, I'm a steady trigger. So long as I've got some caffeine in me.
How could they deny my claim? Look at this place.
I'm sure you're right. All insurance workers are compassionate, honorable people.
Well, the claims fella gives me any lip, he'll find out how persuasive I can be.
What a disturbing euphemism.
Thanks for this, by the by.
Samesies. Uh-oh. Looks like the morning rush has arrived. I'm outie.
He just came, comes through the hole.
Time to make the Frogurts.
Oh no, am I gonna have to actually make some? Oh, for fuck's sakes.
Good morning, welcome to Franz Frogurts. What can I get you today, hon?
A large peanutty buddy with sprinkles.
Peanutty buddy. Didn't know I had to have F as well. Damn. Chucked it. That looks like shit. Oh. Fucking hate this shit. What? I fucking did it. I fucked up.
Here you go, sweetheart.
I've messed up the final hole, though.
Incredible, Fran.
I know, babe.
God damn it. She's not even holding it.
Welcome to Mr. Strongborg's office. Please make yourself comfortable while I inform him of your presence.
You've got to be kidding me. One more thing goes
on. Can I move around?
Apologize for the jabbers. Won't happen again, sir. You cannot lose this job. My idea is a paradigm shift. One that could help Atlas beat the competition. Yeah, that sounds great. Convincing. Job saving, right?
The woo.
Timmy, tell Dr. Dar I'll see her now.
Dr. Dar?
Unfriggin' believable!
The cool CEO. He's also a chair? Insane.
Hello, sir. Mr. Strongfork. Is everything all right? Because I can come back if...
No. Everything's fine. It's fine. I just got a bid again on an ultra-rare Zero Voltlanders figurine. Again. It's an investment, you know what? Forget it. Never mind. Just come on in. Have a seat. Thanks for coming up on such short notice.
There's no place to sit.
Meeting as quickly as possible so we can touch base on the issue of you keep releasing jabbers on the ship again. You've got to stop doing that. And also, we're in space. We're all contained animals up here, Dr. Dar.
I did release them, and I'm not sorry. I will not condone, and I certainly will not participate in the needless torture of animals under the guise of scientific research, a byproduct of a capitalist system that thrives on violence.
Wait. Why does this sound weirdly familiar?
Oh, maybe because I wrote an entire mission statement about... Wait. You read my mission statement?
Oh, God, the memo. That's right. Yeah, They were upgrading some of the circuitry in my office, and the bathroom door got stuck. So I had some time. I mean, a lot of time to kill. And things got kind of desperate. I'm just saying I read every page that I used.
Oh, God.
What the hell?
You've proven that I can't trust you to follow corporate regulations. And what's more, you cost me a fortune. Do you have any idea? Any? I have guys in R&D working on cold fusion-powered giant robots who spend less money than you've wasted on freeing animals from their cages. And Iridium Ore. Oh my God, the Iridium Ore. If I'd seen any evidence at all, a shred of it, that you had been using that Iridium Ore to make something that, you know, we could sell or patent or eat, I wouldn't care, but... Now that... It's a pretty interesting little gun there, huh? Look at it, all gun-shaped.
This is no gun, Mr. Strongfork. This is my...
Device.
Device.
Okay.
This device... Gun. This device is going to achieve something no one ever has. Something no one has come close to. Replicating the powers of a siren with the pull of a trigger!
Now that's a pitch! Keep going, keep going.
Keep going, keep going.
This is exciting. The cold fusion robot guys, they give a fun presentation, but it's always, you know, a little much.
This is the most powerful man-made creation in the world. You need this, and you need me.
Ooh, assertive. That's good. It's wrong, but it's good.
Sorry?
Anything you develop on Atlas property with Atlas money belongs to Atlas, so I don't technically need you to have that. But like I said, the, you know, the raw energy, that's great.
Right.
Okay. Decent pitch.
Shit.
I give it a C-. Enough to not get you fired. Yet.
We still look skinny, though.
So, I'm gonna need a demonstration
unhealthy,
to see what this adorable little game changer of yours can do.
Absolutely, sir. If you have space in your schedule in 2 weeks' time...
Now? I meant now. There's no time like the present, right? So, present!
But I haven't... It hasn't... It's in progress, and...
It doesn't do anything, does it?
No, no, it does. Just let me explain.
Oh, by all means. And by all means, I mean this had better be really, really good, or you're fired.
It's an energy manipulator, designed to move any tangible subject through space-time.
Move through?
Transport, yes.
It's a phase-walk gun?
It's a phase-walk device. A...
Phaser!
A phaser.
A totally non-lethal, utterly decisive way to end any conflict.
Wait. Non-lethal?
Yes.
So... To clarify, you have spent all the money and resources at your disposal that I gave you from my disposal to build a gun that does not kill people?
I've built a device.
Gun.
Device that doesn't kill. It just sends people on a little vacation.
A vacation to death?
No, just a vacation. They literally vacate.
Our customers don't want to send people on vacation. They want to send them to death. Okay, okay. You know what? Show me. Show me, or put it on the desk, and leave my office!
Okay. I think you're really going to like this, sir.
What are you gonna shoot?
I am waiting to be deeply, deeply impressed here. I mean, floored, really, at this point, and I've seen some shit, so... Bar is high.
It's just three options?
It worked. It did it. It didn't kill it or blow it up. It just
went on vacation.
Went away.
That was a plant from the very first Atlas biodome that I... It has sentimental value. That plant tried to kill me and Sasha on our first date. And it's also proprietary Atlas bioengineering and worth like $1 billion. Okay, okay, okay. Impressive.
Well,
very
I wasn't
impressive.
Gonna shoot
now,
the suit.
You know, reverse phase. Unzap. De-eliminate. Bring it back.
There's no reverse switch, sir. It only does the one thing. So far. It's a prototype.
So far.
How did it send my stuff?
I, do not know.
So it's just gone? Maybe. Maybe it'll find a way to grow out there. Maybe it'll put down roots and grow.
It has to be kept in specially enriched soil and receive 5 daily feedings of a proprietary Atlas mineral mixed in deionized water to survive being removed from the biosphere in which it was genetically engineered.
Damn.
Mr. Strongfork! CEO of the Atlas Company. I am your assistant.
Yeah, Timmy, I know.
Then now is my time to shine! Let me assist you!
Wait, 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 Timmy, what?
I will go on a quest to retrieve what you have lost, rescue mission!
You would do that? For me?
Of course I would! Mr. Strongfork! CEO of the Atlas Company! Anything and everything for you is literally the purpose of my existence.
Yikes.
Yeah, well, that's a fair point, actually. Alright. Dr. Dar? Let's try this again. On Timmy.
I'm ready!
Timmy?
Well, she's not there.
Timmy! If he doesn't come back, you'll be hearing from me. Specifically, the sound of my tears.
He'll definitely come back. I think.
Someday.
Someday.
Can I just say, for a gun...
device.
...that's designed to be non-lethal, that thing is really doing some damage.
Thank... you?
Not a compliment. You can't control it, you barely know what it does, except that it doesn't kill things, which makes it useless.
It isn't designed to kill. Not everything needs to harm people.
I feel harmed. I feel very personally harmed. Just not in a way that's profitable. Oh my god, why? Oh, Timmy, where are you when I need you most?
You've reached Rhys Strongfork, the CEO of Atlas Corporation.
Well, well, if it isn't Rhys Strongfork.
Susan Coldwell. CEO of TDR. Why are you calling me? You know what? Can you hold on for just a sec? Dr. Dar, you may go. And if it wasn't clear already, you're fired.
But, sir...
God damn it.
Susan, how'd they hang in?
Oh. Perky as ever, Rhys. And you? Eyes and limbs all accounted for?
Oh, yep. All good over here. Doing just great. Better than... Was there, something you needed?
Would I still get fired if I shot something else? I don't know.
I can't kill my targets until they say their full name out loud, and I am able to confirm its match against the name in the database. That's where you come in. So you must get my target to say their full name out loud.
Yeah, I know, this ain't my first rodeo.
What is a rodeo?
What?
Oh! It's when, like, ranchers rad bucking. You know what? Never mind.
Very well.
He's a fucking robot. He doesn't have that in his database.
A man named Jamison Harwin kicked his neighbor's pet scat pup.
Ooh.
So the neighbor contracted me to punish him.
And skags are awful.
No, this one was cool.
I doubt a skag.
It learned how to ride a skateboard.
Oh, shit. I'm mistaken.
You show me that skag-kicking piece of trash right now.
I forget the name. James Harrison or some shit.
Do you have any further questions before we begin the operation? It shouldn't take long.
Yeah, just one. What's your favorite flower?
Posies.
Huh.
Posies?
Posies. A single posy is worthless, but they're delightful in a bunch.
Fair enough.
Posies. Posies. Jameson Harwin lives in that apartment.
Jameson Harwin, okay.
You'll use the buzzer for apartment 3 to get him to come outside.
3.
I will be waiting nearby. With death.
Alright, let's get this gag kicking piece of crap.
Jameson Harwin.
Got a pizza here for apartment 3?
What? I didn't order any pizza.
No offense, but are you by any chance drunk, sir?
Well, yeah. How the hell's that relevant?
Drunk folk order pizza, then forget about it. Happens all the time. Think of me as a present from your past self.
All right.
All right.
Just give me a sec.
Well, I must admit, your methods are strange. It seems to have worked. Now you must get him to say his full name before I can fulfill the contract.
No problem.
I'll just ask for his full name.
Give it here, kid. What gives? I come all the way down here and you don't even got it? You better not be messing with me, boy. I got a hell of a temper.
Oh, dang. I forgot it in the car. I knew I was forgetting something. Before I go, can you confirm your full name for me?
As Jameson Harwin. Now get moving!
Oh, shit!
You just got L0U13. Did I do it right?
Nailed it. That's what you get, scat kicker!
What the fuck is that?
Well done. I have received payment. Here is your commission, friend Octavio.
Ooh, cash money! Make it rain!
Now you gotta pick it all up. The fuck, you stupid?
I'm meeting the Kuropakos. You in?
I am indeed in. Though I still cannot fathom how you can eat food from a man who lives in the sewers and befriends Ratch.
I use a lot of hot sauce.
Fair.
And that's how Papa Girardi makes a space calzone.
Fascinating. I have an additional inquiry. You mentioned your past proclivity for stealing. As you know, many of my contracts have been for idiot petty thieves, such as yourself. Now, your sister.
Anu.
Your sister Anu disapproves of this proclivity and wishes for you to stop stealing. Are you heeding her counsel? It is a dangerous hobby, Larceny.
I'm stealing to survive. Anu knows how hard it is to live in a war zone. She left me here to fend for myself. But of course, why should that stop her from judging me?
It sounds like you're judging her.
Can it, robot?
We all judge. It's in our nature. Well, hello.
Oh, Octavio. Hi.
Louis, let me introduce you to Diamond Danielle, a real thief and definitely not an idiot.
Not an idiot.
That's one way to introduce a friend. Sure.
Greetings. Diamond Danielle must be a moniker. Since it obscures your real name, I have a 0% probability of killing you.
Are you flirting with me, robot?
No.
Real charmer.
He's working on his people skills.
I am not.
We're on our way to Paco's to meet up with Radon. Wanna come?
Tacos. I'm there.
You are not. We must ambulate there.
Ignore him.
Someone left the door open. What the fuck?
How many times do I have to tell you to sweep behind the counter, Octavio? Killing me.
You want to help me? You'll give me what I asked for, and you know damn well what that is.
Henry?
Hank!
What brings you around these parts?
Same as always. You owe me for protection, and my price ain't budging.
You know, usually a protection shakedown involves actually protecting a place. Didn't see you anywhere when Malawan was blasting holes in my store.
Don't blame me for the whims of our corporate overlords. There's only one thing I want, and it's time to pay up.
I'm sorry, but there's no way I can give you a lifetime of free Frogurt, Hank. Not at the rate you eat it.
Why? Huh? Do it! Hey, do it, or I'm gonna kill you!
That's how it's gonna be?
I tried to be patient. But you feed me enough frozen yogurt to keep me on a 24/7 sugar high, or I feed you the tip of this pick!
Take a...
I'm through asking. You're gonna give me what I want, or we're gonna have a dozen flavors worth of problem.
You keep threatening me, and you're not gonna like where this conversation ends up.
Sounds like somebody fell off the anger wagon.
Yeah? Well, you think that makes me more or less worth screwing with?
No, maybe... Maybe I just kill you and take this place over for myself.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be pretty cool.
You got two picks?
And frankly, what'd be the difference? Huh? Whether it be an ice pick to the eye or slowly wasting away in debt to the Tedior Corporation, you are dead. Either way. Face it, Fran. You failed.
You failed.
Maybe you could have been somebody once upon a time, but that was a good 10,000 Frogurts and a Malawan laser ago. You have got nothing. No. I'm sorry, that was too generous. You are nothing.
Here goes nothing.
Headshot.
Get the hell out of my shot.
Oh, she's angry. It's been years since I fought a geriatric. Come on.
Ooh. Are you losing to a geriatric? Come on, use your claws.
Any last words?
I was really hoping this didn't have to get violent.
Far as last words go, 5 out of 10.
Damn.
Oh no! Is that blood? Am I bleeding?
I tried to be nice, but this time you've gone too far.
Yeah, okay, I was about to say. Ooh, ooh. Shout at him, bitch.
Thanks for coming by.
Embrace it!
Berry Blast Zone. Sarsaparilla Shotgun. Probiotic Punch Out!
Probiotics are bunk stuff, just like your coping mechanism.
Fudging hell. Be right with you, dear.
Oh, they're gonna try and inspect. Okay. Oh, no, never mind. Yeah, they're gonna catch him in the back.
What am I gonna do now? Where am I gonna go? I mean, we're in space. I live here.
Octavio gonna say? The way we left things. I know this can work. I just need more time and someone with enough vision to see its potential.
Shoot yourself with it.
Oh, hey, Anu. No big deal or anything, but can you come back to the lab real quick? Like, really, really quick, like, before you get killed?
Killed? That's a little dramatic, Fong. I got fired. It's a setback, sure, but not a death sentence.
What? You got fired? Yikes and a half? That sucks. Wait, does that mean I'm fired too? You know what? Forget it. Not even on my list of things to stress about right now. We are in the middle of a TDR invasion with dudes in body armor and guns of an admittedly lower quality than Atlas's. The whole shebang. So let's go.
An invasion by a rival weapons manufacturer. And I'm fired. And it's not even lunch.
On the upside, the vet sent an echo. Your pet fish is doing great.
Hey!
Wait. I misread. It's, dead.
Fuck!
Sorry.
It's okay. The words look similar.
Yeah, so remember when Malawan tried to stage a hostile force takeover of Atlas back on Promethea?
Of course, I'm from Promethea.
It was devastating for Atlas, and they blew up Strongfork's favorite Frogurt place or something.
No, yeah, actually, my brother works there.
Well, I guess TDR smelt blood in the water and decided it's their turn to take a stab at Atlas because they are a hundo P boarding this facility right now, and it is hostile. Like,
let's shoot them all to oblivion. Hostile.
How do you know all this?
Oh.
Employees of Atlas, let's all give our surprise guests from TDR a warm welcome and show them what makes Atlas the company it is. And by warm welcome, I of course mean show them everything we've been working on lately at close range.
Let's be elsewhere, fast!
You felt weird.
Oh, crap! Hide, hide, hide!
Shoot him with the gun!
If...
most of the vase.
...the bolt key somewhere on your space station, where would you hide it? Boss lady said it's in his office, so that's where we're going.
I just don't underestimate this guy, alright? Affirmative. I heard he ripped his own eyeball out.
It's kind of crazy you don't mess with.
Gentlemen, lovely to see ya. I'd offer you a beverage, but my assistant Timmy was recently teleported to God knows where.
Reese Strongfort, we are here for the vault key and or your bloodied corpse.
Hey, fellas, come on. Come in. Have a seat. Say, would either of you be interested in a career change? We've got some killer benefits.
Could I get a cocktail? What the fuck?
Fired during a hostile takeover? Yeesh! Bet you can kiss your severance package goodbye.
Oh no. I've got it right here. That door wasn't broken the last time I came through it.
That's the thing about hostile takeovers. They're hostile.
You smell like guilt and shame. Did your mommy bring a packed lunch?
Shoot them! Shoot them!
Resistance is highly frowned upon.
I'm frowning!
We're frowning.
You could have shot them, but you know. I guess you don't want to be a heroic.
Looks like we're not the only ones being invaded. They're headed down to Promethea, too. Didn't you say your brother was down there? He's a survivor, right? I'm sure he'll be okay.
Octavio. He's...
I mean, you both came out of that Malawan ordeal okay, yeah?
He's caring, but also careless, if that makes sense.
I think I follow.
He's young enough to think he can do anything, and old enough to get into a lot of serious trouble because of it. I have to get down there and find him. He needs me.
Well, hear me out. Maybe you let your brother save his own life while you save yours.
You don't have a brother, do you?
Only child. But I always imagine it'd be like...
having a pet? What the fuck?
There isn't a life for me with Atlas. And there isn't a life worth living if it doesn't include Octavio in it. So I'm getting off of this tin can, one way or another.
Well, there's only one way. And it's with a launch pod.
Follow me.
Hope you're healthy. Extra wounds.
You'd find out if you could land a hit.
I'm trying. Don't be mean.
Don't be mean.
Covering fire.
Shoot them! Come on, when are you gonna shoot?
How am I gonna get into a launch pod without being noticed?
By asking me to cause one hell of a distraction.
You'd do that for me?
No, sure. Just shoot them with
you
your gun, with your device.
You may not have noticed with your head buried in your research, but we're friends. This is what friends do. And besides, causing a scene, that's something at which I excel.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, don't mention it. Seriously, I have a reputation to uphold. You be careful out there, all right?
You too, please.
Oh, and hey, take this from me. I don't want these TDR bastards getting their hands on my lucky Vaultlander. It'll
Who's
be
the Vaultlander?
Is this you?
Yeah, I won it in a stupid contest or whatever. No big deal. It's just like the only one in existence. Super rare and wasted on someone who doesn't play. But whatever, just get out of here before I change my mind.
Fong. Thanks again.
Right. So, I'm headed back that way. You go this way. There's a launch pod ahead. Make sure you get yourself in it. Hey, Tedior! I hear you're looking for a vault key. I know exactly where Strongford put it. Ooh, quick question, though. Are any of you allergic to jabbers?
I would be sure they left... would leave like one behind to go to the launch pad, but you know, that's just me. Take the gun.
I'm sorry, I'm about to profit off your violent end. Hold on, Octavio. I'm coming.
How did he even die? Ooh. What? Huh? I'm confused. Damn. But it's for impact. Oh, it's a car. Damn. Oh, shit. Damn, how are you going so fast? Yeah, go.
You've reached your destination.
That was Reese's call? God damn.